Thank you so much, Dr. Jenny, for such a nice introduction and welcoming. A very warm good morning to each and everyone present in this literacy virtual national webinar. First of all, I am very thankful to Dr. S. Ramu, Dr. T. Nambi, Dr. Gopinathan, and special thanks to Dr. Prabhakaran for inviting me and giving opportunity to share my idea on agricultural waste management on vermicomposting on this virtual national webinar. Last but not the least, I am very thankful to all the participants who are present here. Okay, sir. Shall I share my screen? Is this visible, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
My slide is visible.
Yes, visible, ma'am. One minute. Agricultural waste, yeah.
Agricultural waste management in relation to vermicomposting. First slide. Okay, sir?
Yes.
Is it?
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Visible.
I am going to present my talk on agricultural waste management in relation to vermicomposting. As we all know that agriculture is the backbone of our country and the quality of soil is deteriorating with frequent agrochemicals used. So, restore soil health, we should focus on minimizing agricultural waste and use of vermicomposting technology is most cost effective and sustainable for farmers so they can adopt it. What is agricultural waste? Okay, agricultural solid waste are produced mainly from farming activities which may allow to accumulate indiscriminately and constitute nuisance to global health and threat to food security or used as raw material for bioeconomy. The benefit of recycling of agricultural solid waste include reduction of greenhouse gas emission and use as fossil fuel as well as contributing significantly to development of new green markets, creation jobs, and production of bioenergy and bioconversion of agricultural solid waste to animal feed. With the use of this vermicomposting technology and agricultural waste management, we can achieve doubling farmer and income target along with Clean India mission, which was launched by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Das Modi, Modi ji, a step forward, Atmanirbhar Bharat. Okay. These are some pics: roadside agricultural waste and home generated agricultural solid waste. First one is paddy waste management. Lots of crop residue that are left in the field, and biochar is a most important carbon rich material produced by incomplete combustion of biological material in the absence of oxygen or with limited amount of oxygen. Agricultural waste and wheat biomass can also be used to produce biochar. It is reported by several scientists that the biochar store carbon in the soil for 100 to 1000 of the year. And thus the level of greenhouse gases like CO2 and CH4 can be reduced significantly from the atmosphere in order to make biochar from biomass like lantana camara and paddy also and maize stalk and pine needles material. They can also, from this, we can also produce biochar. Okay. And the salient feature, we can, biochar are produced from the agricultural waste and wheat by using pyrolysis method. Okay. And this can improve soil fertility and crop yield. Sorry. Please switch mute. Someone asking something. Dr. Prabhakaran, can you hear me? Excuse me?
Okay, ma'am. No problem, madam.
Okay. Actually, some voice is coming from background. That's why I'm asking.
Okay, ma'am. I'll manage it, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am.
And in India, produces more than 620 million tons of agricultural waste annually, of which only 25 to 30% part is utilizing waste, okay, as a livestock fodder and energy production. Most of the Indian farmers are practicing residue burning practices to clear the field in rice, wheat, and cropping system for timely sowing of the next crop. The reason is low nutritive value and more cost of labor to clear the field. And this crop residue burning causes air pollution by releasing harmful gases, CO2, CH4, N2O, H2S, and oxygen and smog. Okay. And which largely affect public life and disturb soil, physical, biological and chemical properties by destroying beneficial soil microorganisms. Implementation of effective agricultural waste management can not only solve the air pollution problem, but also provide better input to crop. So the objective of agricultural waste management to minimum waste production and waste to new products like methane, farm utilization of waste and maximum employment and income generation around the year. Okay, so with the help of agricultural waste management, we can also clear our environment, which is the main our mission. And advantage of the agricultural waste management increase economic yield per unit area, per unit time, and also soil health and fertility, and better utilization of farming labor, and minimize the use of harmful chemical so that our soil deteriorating day by day. And we can also recycling the resources, and we can create pollution-free environment. Next one is fruit waste management. Okay, we know that the fruit and vegetables are the rich source of phytochemicals. They have the antioxidant property, and the waste generated during and after processing of fruit and vegetables, they can be processed in different food products. Okay, and production of various bioactive compounds like polyphenol and dietary fibers and enzyme proteins can be done, and also industrial application of bioactive compounds as like pharmaceutical and nutraceuticals and chemical industry, and also in food sectors. And we know that in most of the fruits and vegetables, only the flesh or pulp is consumed. But studies have revealed that significant amount of phytochemicals, as I said, that essential nutrients are present in the seed and peels and other component of the fruits and vegetables are commonly consumed. The peel of lemon, grapes and orange, and seeds of the jackfruit and mangoes contain more than 15% of higher phenolic concentration than that found in the fruit pulp. So it is important to point that fruit vegetable waste management waste are prone to microbial spoilage and causing objectable order and environmental problems. So we should have to keep in mind this fruit waste management also in agricultural waste. First one is pineapple waste. As we know that pineapple Waste consists of residual skin, peel, pulp, and stem and leaves, which are raw material of the pineapple processing industry. With the increasing production of pineapple, there will be massive generation of waste product. From this product, we can synthesize different kinds of the products like ethanol, citric acid, lactic acid, and fibers. And this slide shows that how can from jamun we can also produce useful product from the mature ripe fruit of the jamun. Juice is extracted, and from the dried from the seed we can produce powder. And this is an important ingredient for the making tablets and other products in the diabetic patients. Okay. And some other uses of the jamun seed, which is used in folk medicine, like yodhana, paste of seed along with the combination of leaves of cassia auriculata, they used to treat diabetic patients. And also powder of seeds are taken orally thrice a day, as I said by Nagaraju et al. In 2006. Banana waste management. Damaged banana and banana bunch stock can be converted into gaseous fuel by anaerobic digestion, a process in which bacteria break down carbohydrate in the absence of air, producing a mixture of methane and carbon dioxide. In fact, all materials can be processed in this way. The inflorescence of banana plant contain a huge amount of nutritious value. Eating the flower help in increasing the menstrual health and keeping away infections. The flower has been proven to have antimicrobial property, promote kidney function, and also help in reducing anxiety. The banana leaves. In India, banana leaves have been used since ages in temples for religious offerings to God, to being used as a serving plate at restaurant, and also using it as a wrapper for steamed food preparation, especially in Kerala and South also. Here in North India, we use as a banana leaves used as a serving plate at home and also restaurants. From banana waste, we can also produce miscellaneous kinds of organic products and dyes and pesticides. In this slide, we can see that from banana root, with the help of this power plant, we can generate pure methane gas, okay, and also different kind of banana chips and banana pulp and banana jams and foods can be prepared from the this banana peels and banana peels and whole banana. And this slide show that sugar cane waste product can be utilized in the production of the sugar and ethanol and generation of the electricity also. Some of the products are prepared from the ICR, like this product, preparation of handmade paper from the jute waste, SN Chattopadhyay of the ICR. And the benefits of this jute waste product, hand paper product, conserve resources and generate less pollution. And producing handmade paper use much less total energy than producing virgin paper. Reduce total number of trees cut down to make paper. So afforestation it increases and deforestation is avoided. And utilization of corn cob powder for kulhad making. The corn cob powder is mixed in different ratio with mud and cup and prepared baking the mold cup in a direct fire. The corn cob powder can be added up to 15% and further addition reduce the physical and thermal property of the cup. So the agricultural biomass residue can partially be used for making cups along with mud. This type of biomass utilization provide an alternate solution for disposal of corn cob residues. And other technology of growing oyster mushroom on coconut waste. And this was developed by ICAR CPRI Kerala by George B. Thomas. Mushroom produced on coconut waste is nutritionally rich and medicinally important food item. It contains 20 to 30%, we all know, protein on dry weight basis and a rich source of mineral, vitamin C and vitamin B complex. The technology does not need any additional and requirement and utilizes the waste material available in farmers' coconut gardens. The spent mushroom substrate obtained after harvesting of mushroom can be used for compost and vermicomposting production. So coconut peat also can used and coconut waste also used as an important substrate for the vermicompost production, which I will take in the next slide. Coconut waste compost adds soilless medium. Soilless medium is entirely coconut based recycled product. It fully organic and of sustainable nature. It adds in quick germination of seeds and production of disease-free organically raised seedling. The seedling raised in soilless medium develop root system and it can be used for the production of seedling of high value vegetable flour, spices and even plantation crop. As we know that in hydroponic culture is very burning topic in these days, and we can also use coconut milk and coconut for the, because cytokinin present in this coconut, we can generate a callus and a plant in tissue culture and in lab. Management of recycling agro waste. Agro waste, this agro waste can be, as you told by Sweta madam, biofertilizers and bioremediation. So agro waste can be utilized in biofertilizer and also in alcohol production and fuel and phosphorus and calcium production, pulp and paper industries. This diagram show that how these are the actually agricultural waste. So source of agricultural solid waste may be animal production solid waste and food and meat processing solid waste and crop production solid waste, on farm medical solid waste and horticulture production solid waste, industrial agriculture solid waste and chemical waste. And so first, if we have to take the animal production solid waste, so on farm, such wastes include like animal carcasses and damaged feeders and water trough, and food and meat processing solid waste. Food and meat processing agricultural solid waste include hoops, bones and feeders and banana peels. They include in green waste. And also crop production solid waste are associated with agricultural solid waste, typically produced from agriculture activity involving crop production. And such agricultural solid waste are crop residue like husk, straw and stubbles. And on farm medical solid waste, refer to solid waste that are generated from the use of drugs, insecticides and vaccines used on animals. And such waste include vaccines, wrappers and containers, disposables, needles and syringe. And some agricultural waste also from the horticulture, like the maintenance and cultivation of the horticultural plants and landscape for beautification. Okay. And such wastes are pruning and grass cutting. Okay, and from the industrial agricultural solid waste, food processing and cutting readily come to the mind as a source of agricultural solid waste. So paper production using agricultural products as raw material also generates some quantity of agricultural solid waste. So straw and stubble and green waste and dry waste from farm and kitchen waste and roadside waste, all are the substrate for the vermicomposting technology. As told by the Sweta madam, she told large scale and a small scale production of the vermi technology and different kind of microbiota and earthworm, different kind of earthworm, especially Yersinia foetida is using in these days. And so treatment process composting is the most important tool. Vermicomposting is the most important tool to regenerate our soil health, because at first, whenever vermicomposting unit is established, then at first preparation of the agricultural waste, we have to prepare agricultural waste and solid waste for the substrate, and then decomposition, and then the product of preparation, and then marketing. Okay. In this slide, we can see that how earthworm can be collected by observing earthworm casting, and we can construct vermi bed And this can be on the larger scale, on the smaller scale, even in the garden, even in the home premises, and even in the institutes. And the separation of the earthworm and solid waste, after that packaging done, and then the transportation and marketing to the greenhouses and nurseries and the gardeners. So vermicomposting, from the vermicomposting, vermicompost and vermiwash is produced, as Sweta madam told, because her research work, extensive research work on vermicomposting. So vermicompost improves plant growth and increases microbial activity, and it suppresses plant diseases and also enhances water retention and aeration. Okay, and also nutrient recycling, it helps in nutrient recycling also. So vermicomposting, compost technology is an emerging technology for recycling of crop residues and other organic solid waste by the utilization of earthworm to convert them into vermicompost. Vermicompost is a nutrient-rich compost which helps better plant growth and crop yield, and also improve physical structure of the soil and increase water holding capacity of the soil, enhance germination and plant growth and crop yield, and also improve root growth of the plant, and enriches soil with the different kind of the plant hormones like auxin and gibberellin. And it also, I told that the better utilization of the family labor, even I can establish a small vermicomposting unit at my home. Because I am working upon it since six months only, and because I'm basically I'm a botanist, and I have a great interest in this vermicomposting technology, so I have started this with the permission of my honorable vice chancellor sir. He is very interested in this vermicomposting and organic farming technology. So conclusion of my talk. So we have to move waste to wealth and reducing the environmental pollution, and also looking for substitute of petrol and diesel, and increase quality of farm manure, and also medicinal use of cow urine and dung. And one more thing I want to say, that the influence of this agricultural production on human health, this change in climate. So it has been suggested that greenhouse gas emission need to be reduced drastically to avoid the impending threat to the on the planet. So we have to aware all the farmers who are involved, and all the people, and proper awareness should be made to everyone involved in agricultural activity, whether at a woman farmer and consumers, on the effect of indiscriminate disposal of agricultural solid waste, waste, and benefit of efficient management of agricultural solid waste. And also political leaders should be open-minded and formulate policies that ensure the efficient recycling of agricultural solid waste, and appropriate funds should be allocated to achieving this. So attention should be focused on minimizing waste by creating a more efficient, sustainable agriculture supply chain through the development of sustainable, durable market. And one of the most important tool of the management of this agricultural waste is vermicomposting or vermitechnology. I am without wasting my time. I will not take much more time. Thank you so much, because next speaker is waiting. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Very excellent lecture. Very nice. One more question, madam. Pineapple and coconut plant, which part of more essential for waste management? Solid waste management, ma'am.
Hear you, please repeat once again.
Yeah.
Pineapple and coconut plant. Pineapple and coconut plant, which part more essential solid waste management, ma'am?
So actually coconut, actually I told now that coconut coconut peat is most essential in the generation of the it used as a substrate for the vermicomposting and all the technology which is used in composting.
Ma'am?
Okay, madam. Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Ma'am, good morning.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Good morning.
I am Dr. Anbaragan from Zoology Department, Vivekananda Arts and Science College, Tiruchengod, Namakkal District. This is one of the very wonderful organizations and very well effort on the informative sessions on the vermiculture and vermitech. I hope this is very useful for all other peoples.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Ma'am?
Yes, sir.
I asking small questions.
Yes, sir.
What is the most benefit for the vermic wash or vermic compost?
Vermic wash, actually it can be used as a liquid fertilizer. Vermic wash you can use as a liquid fertilizer, and vermic compost you can use as a manure. So vermic wash is most important than the vermic compost.
Which is one most effective in how to use for the plant?
If you want to apply vermi wash as a because it is a liquid, in the liquid form, then you can apply as a sprinkled, okay, and the vermi compost you can use in the manure. Okay
One question.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for a very nice reply.
Yes, sir. Actually, I have just started work from since 6 months because I am botanist. So I am also learning from this. And Shweta madam has extensive work on this. And I have seen that lots of questions arises in that session, and most of the doubts cleared at that time. So more questions are welcome because. Sir, you are asking something, Dr. R. Raza Mani Ram, sir.
Yeah.
I have seen that you have lots of work on medicinal plants. You told the earlier lecture, so you can ask, sir. I will try to give answer.
No, yes. Sir, it's not a complicated question, but basic question only, because we are preparing panchagavya for plant as well as
okay yes,
yeah, panchagavya as well as for human consumption. So, but we gave this human consumption panchagavya to many people from past 4 or 5 years. But I got a very good result also from the public. The only thing is, scientifically, I am unable to prove that. That's all. Do you have any experience about this panchagavya of human consumption?
Yes, sir.
Ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Are you using panchagavya, human consumption?
I have listened panchagavya that has prepared from 5 things of from the kauna, like urine and
yes.
Welcome.
Panchagavya. I have heard. Because lots of extensive work on Guru Prasad sir from BHU, he has done work on panchagavya.
Okay. No. Some people, they are preparing for only for human consumption.
Okay. I think it is anti-carcinogenic.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. But it works very well.
Anti-carcinogenic. I have seen.
We are preparing.
Okay.
We are preparing. Ma'am.
He also told me that, Sunita, you apply this panchagavya on the plant because I'm basically, yes. I'm doing plant physiology work. So I give a different kind of a stress on the plant. So he told me that you apply this panchagavya on plant, and then you can see the effect of this panchagavya. But I have not yet started, I will do in the future also.
It works,
sir. For panchagavya, thank you, sir.
It works. Yeah, it works very well.
Madam, Sunita ma'am. Okay. Any questions, sir? Sadiq sir, welcome.
Sir.
Dr. Sadiq sir, welcome.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Thank
you. Sir, ma'am, my permission. Yeah. I welcome Dr. C. Lakshmi Narasimhan sir. Dr. C. Lakshmi Narasimhan sir, former head of the department, AM Sri Pushpam College, and also research advisor, Rich University. he established a unit, let me come to the unit at the president.